Right, okay, so we gotta do some spells!
Yeah!
All right.
While they're thinking of looking at spells to do, let me remind you that here at Saving Throw, we have a lot of great shows you can watch. We have Never Tell Me the Odds on Fridays, alternating with Black Bag.
Woo!
Who doesn't love Cthulhu? Everyone is scared of Cthulhu. On Saturdays, we have
Masks.
Mm-hmm. With the safety pins, teenage superheroes attacking, defending the world.
Yes.
And we have Phoenix Dawn Command. What? On
where I also play a monstrous thing.
Also monstrous.
Yeah.
On alternating Wednesdays, we have This Misadventures, the best of all of the shows.
Yes.
And Lost Brigade, which is D&D 5th edition.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have your spells?
Yes. To the window, to the wall. I'm going to knock one of those monsters down on the ground.
That's one of your set spells, so you can cast that without effort, correct?
Absolutely.
Who are you gonna knock to the wall?
That big gorilla bull.
The gorilla bull.
Gorilla bull. Mr. Ridge bull.
This is gorilla bull.
To the window, to the wall. Ah!
He's now stuck to the wall until such time as
till he can. Further notice.
Till further notice.
I'm gonna cast Stupefy on her.
Stupefy. Uh-oh.
I'm trying to remember the exact.
That's a bad idea, dear.
A bad idea.
Not a bad idea.
Oh, I was like, what did I do?
No,
I'm
great
trying to remember
idea.
It's a level two?
It's a level two.
So, I have all this written down, I promise. I have to beat a 10 to roll it.
Yep.
Hmm. Cast.
Can she do it?
Barely
cast Stupefy. But you've cast Stupefy on Jaina. But you're in your wolf form. You're not a wizard.
No.
So if you were a wizard, you would get a chance to fight back. But as a wolf.
Probably not as
probably
much.
Not. You're just like, stupefied.
Growl snarl.
Growl snarl. So you're going to sit there stupefied, but guys, Deerilla is still here. And Deerilla is mad. It's Jason Deerilla.
Terrible.
Don't let me say things like that.
Yeah, right.
We can't stop you. The best revenge we could have is letting you say the things that you're going to say.
That's true. Okay, so who's here?
And I was never invited to play this game
we're
again.
We're here. We're here running to mix stuff with the muffins. This is Leah, Amelia.
This is happening over here.
Here's, and then
this is the wall that's somehow in the middle of the square.
Of course. Love it.
And here's Darilla. Darilla. Who's Darilla want? Which tasty, tasty morsel is Darilla? Both of those animals are vegetarian, but Darilla wants meat.
Okay.
Darilla wants blood.
This is what happens when you mess magically, creating magical creatures.
Makes sense.
You mess up. Whoa! Darilla is uncoordinated. Give me back that. Darilla swings his head around, but the body just doesn't match. So just like swinging his horns, can't hit anything. Bad. It's bad. Poor Darilla.
Okay. Is this happening in sight of my shop? I can't tell. Just based on this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks like
it's
it.
Just right outside your shop.
I mean, it is Chicken Bear Day.
It is Chicken Bear Day, so you're naturally going to assume that this is some kind of prank.
Right.
What on earth would lead you to believe that this wasn't a prank?
Probably these two running into the shop.
Are you going to run into the shop?
Yeah.
Are you gonna?
That's where we're headed.
We run in, slam the door.
I'll just hang out in the street then, shall I?
You're stupefied at the moment.
We're trying to figure out what to do.
But Jason Derulo is out there and is ready to gore.
You guys run.
We're gonna.
What? Oh, hi. Hi, Jen.
Hi.
So, Jenna just turned into a werewolf. In the middle of, somehow.
And that's where the moon is out. Someone pulled a prank, I think. The moon.
Oh. All right, well, you know that I am, my animagus form is a wolf. Maybe I can help. Maybe I don't know.
Do a shock, not a
bad thing. Right now she's stupefied. We need some help, though.
Oh.
And there is a Darilla outside the door.
A gorilla bull.
Jason Darilla.
Well,
Jason, I think his name might be Jason. I'm not sure.
Oh. Jason. That's a lot of information that you have there.
Yes, I know. He's... might be, oh, well, I think.
He's dressed very snappily.
He is. Oh. I think one of my grands might have made it.
Oh, no. Oh,
wow.
Grandchildren are involved in illegal creature making.
They are.
Oh, I'm
so proud.
I am. You know, you're proud of what your grandchildren do.
Even when it's making horrible, horrible monsters.
He's right here, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'm like right pretty much out from the door. Right. So I'm just going to open the door and cast Flippendo, which is one of my spells.
Do it.
So I do, right? That's how that works? Okay. Flippendo!
And it's D4?
Yeah. But Drilla's tough. He's a freaking
one. I mean, come on, one.
Ow! Like
That's
one of his
right.
little antlers, like chips off a little bit.
Take that,
my antler!
I wish I knew some Jason Derulo songs right now because I'm totally singing them in that voice. He's a singer, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm not cool.
I made a reference. Is it the right reference?
Thank you. I'm not a cool person.
I don't know that any of us are.
Yeah.
I couldn't sing any for you either. It's okay.
All right.
All I know is he says his name a lot.
You step outside. Yes. You Flippendo Darilla. Darilla Flippendos and gets slightly hurt. But you know what? Because I'm feeling evil. You Flippendo him into Gorilla Bull and knock him out of to the window, to the wall, and he's back in play!
Oh, and now he's mad!
Hey, which one would this be? That or normal?
Oh, you're gonna be normal.
Okay. All right, so.
Monsters have gone. So it's
gone.
Back to you guys.
All right,
you just went.
Okay.
These guys.
Oh, I see.
We need to figure out a plan to get taken out. Mm-hmm. Everyone's gonna think it's a prank, so we need to figure out how to get to clear the square.
To clear the square?
What?
Truly?
Everybody's watching and going like, what a great prank! This is the best prank I've seen! We need to make some kind of award for pranks and call it the Chicken Bear Award!
Well, I could turn at least one of them into a sexy male dancer. I do have that spell, and maybe that will help bring him, you know, make him at least more entertaining, more palatable moment. Okay, so to the Gorilla Bull, I say, Incantatum Channing Tatum. I believe in miracles. Where you from? Eating sexy thing. Oh my goodness. Woo.
Oh my gosh, and Gorilla Bull turned into a sexy, sexy dancing man with some gold sparkly hot pants.
Yeah, that's
Is he British handsome?
No,
he's Channing Tatum sexy.
He's network TV handsome.
Ooh, that's a step up from British handsome.
Oh yeah, he is network TV handsome, and he is like gyrating. Oh, and he's got a six pack, like deep ruts in that six pack.
Oh, I'm already feeling better about this.
Now remember, he's not human. Just remember.
Right, but the dancing's so good.
He's dancing. Like hard.
Oh no, we still have that Darilla Bull.
So I'm gonna use Stupefy on the Darilla.
Darilla.
The Jason Darilla.
Okay. Which... Although, honestly, let's all be honest, Jason Darilla should have been turned into a dancing man. That would have been right and just.
You need to invent a spell that makes them sing songs.
There is one.
I think it's gonna have to be cast just for the sake.
No!
Ooh.
Didn't do it.
Uh-oh.
Amelia's not a spellcaster.
A three means that you cast something else, not what you intended.
I rolled a nine.
For it was a nine?
Yeah.
Oh, still.
For future reference, Cantus causes the victim to burst into uncontrollable song.
Ooh.
There we go.
There we go.
I think we know it's next.
Brought to you by really alphabetizing the crap out of things.
Beautiful.
I haven't had a chance to print out.
So. I
made it.
No.
Well. I lost my chart.
Yes.
Oh, no.
This terrible fundamentally disorganized. Trying to eat everyone.
But rolling a nine means that instead of casting the spell you wanted to spell, you are going to cast Lumos.
Stupid. Lumos?
Yep. Lawn lights up. Everyone's looking at you. They're like, this prick has layers.
Defense against the dark arts.
Brilliant.
Not my strong suit.
Clearly, dear. I'm so sorry.
You guys have gone. You are napping, but Gorilla
having
Bull
a little dream.
Gorilla Bull's still dancing.
Gorilla Bull dances right into you, Jaina.
Uh-oh.
You are roused. I know, I'm so evil today.
But like in like the want to bite something way and not like another
You're not
way.
Aroused.
Okay, cool. Just you checking, are, I'm checking. There's a lot going on right roused. Now. Like somebody just turned into a sexy dancer.
Yeah.
I need to
I can
clarify.
See the mistake. I can see the mistake.
Okay, okay.
You're, you know what, you'll, were you down one round?
Yes.
You woke up this round. If next round, you'll get an action. Gorilla Bull is dancing, but he's gonna try and bitch slap somebody.
Wow.
I shouldn't have said that, I apologize, but he is successful. Who is closest? Are you?
I'm right there.
We're all over there.
You're nowhere near my guys. They're over here.
I think Cthulhu here once.
Oh. Cthulhu is just watching, being like, someone did a terrible prank to me, but it's happening to someone else. Oh, this is the worst prank anyone's ever done to me. Tentacle mouth.
Imagine he sounds like Zoidberg,
though.
Yeah. Zoidberg.
Yeah.
Oh, Zoidberg.
Dom loves it.
No, the worst Zoidberg is, hi, I'm Zoidberg. 2 points of damage, Tara.
Ouch!
Oh, ouch! There's Darilla. Who is he going after? Mm. Why is everyone's head down?
I don't know.
Not me.
I'm just trying to make sure my AC.
Right, I know. I was like, what do I have again?
It's been a while.
Can you beat, does 11 beat your AC?
No.
Dang it. He swings his head at you. But you know, like, he's like, he swings it like this. Mm-hmm. He's like, oh, Jason Derulo.
You remind me too much of Jack.
Oh, thank you. So what we're doing real quickly is we're building off of Pathfinder rules, although we've clearly jiggered them terribly. And so the roll to hit is that each of these characters has an AC on their character sheet, and the roll has to be higher than their AC to hit them. That AC takes into account their armor and their quickness and anything that they would do to prevent themselves from being hit. So if Darilla, your AC would have been what?
Mine's 12.
12. So Darilla had to roll over a 12 to actually hit. Mm-hmm. And he rolled an 11. Because he's a lot more beauty.
He's not bigger than Beast. He's dancing
than
too
Beast.
Hard.
He's a lot more beauty than Beast.
Can you explain how a spell does not go right?
I will explain how a spell does not go right. In the Harry Potter universe, when the students are trying to cast a spell that they're not super familiar with or not really good at, they will sometimes miss, but they'll cast a different spell. So if these guys, they have their spells laid out for them and their spells are different levels. So based on the difficulty of the spell, they have to roll a higher and higher number to actually cast it. If they don't cast it, they're going to cast something else. And if they roll a 1, whatever they were trying to cast, they cast on themselves. Unless they were trying to cast it on themselves, and then they cast it on someone super inconvenient.
Oh no!
Those are the rules we're playing by. It's fun and it's crazy.
It is crazy. Crazy.
And now, but Jason Darilla is out there barely hurt and ready to rumble, and he just he's like, barely missed you.
I just have hair in my face.
Yeah, you totally get. Jason Derulo's got a lot of hair.
I'm getting that feeling.
Yeah. And now we're back to the top of the order. So that's you three.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so wait, when do I hop in? Do I hop in?
You hop in with them.
I hop in with them. Okay. I'm going to turn into a wolf.
Do it.
Right. I don't know how I do that. How do I do that?
She's a bit rusty. It's been a while.
A bit rusty.
I would say that's just a spell that you cast on yourself, but it's one of your.
Yeah.
It's not like it's one of your known spells, so you're gonna make it.
Okay.
But it just takes up your spell casting for that turn.
That makes sense. So here I am as a wolf now.
People are looking at this, being like, Whoa, these pranks are blowing my mind! It's so many pranks!
Prankception.
There are like little prank fans over here going, I want to learn to do that. And that leads to your new complication. People are now rushing into the middle of your battle to congratulate you on your pranks.
No!
Oh, no.
Oh, my gosh, that was so good. I love pranks. They're my favorite. I want to do pranks like you someday. All here in the middle. Ooh, I look like Cthulhu and it sucks, but what you're doing is so cool.
Oh, my goodness.
Everybody read my book!
Yeah. It's for sale across the street!
It's for sale across the street.
So
I'm
go ahead.
I'm just gonna try and cast Flipendo on Darilla. Jason Darilla.
Sure, Flipendo him.
Flipendo.
Which should be, is that another level two? Is that a level two?
Flipendo is two.
Okay.
If you guys are interested in seeing the spells and the levels, all the spells that they're using.
20!
Dead Gummit!
Oh.
Well, in most D&D, when you roll a natural 20, you get a chance to crit.
Crit.
So roll
crit.
Again.
Roll to confirm.
If you roll a number that hits at all, you've critted.
Okay. What hits the Darilla? Let's find out.
Oh, because it's just
oh, yeah,
for
it's
your
10.
In your case,
yeah,
it's like, true. Are you casting the spell?
14!
Yes! This Flipendo is about to be like a super intense Flipendo. Like Jason Darilla is going up in the air and spinning a few times. Triple damage.
Triple damage. So can I steal some D4s?
D4.
Here. Like one from everyone. So you
the
know,
spells
luck.
That we're using are mostly Harry Potter spells from the books and movies, yeah. But we're also inventing our own to add to it to fill out the world. So Flipendo is an actual Harry Potter spell.
Yes, it
Jeez.
Is. That's not a very good roll, but that's a roll.
Well,
four.
Still, seven.
Seven.
Seven, yeah.
7 points of damage.
Yeah, that's the same die.
So like, and I do.
Jason Darilla, he flies the in the air and he's flipping one. Around, but it's real graceful like, right? With lots of great moves.
He's like twisting.
Yeah, I think they are the same.
Right, yeah. And he comes down, like on his hand, and it's almost like he's gonna do a handstand, but he hits it wrong. And like it gives out, and like he's like, oh, breaks his gorilla arm. And he's like, oh, that's like, it sounds like a wolf, but I was supposed to sound like singing. You know
what? I got you.
You're on top of that.
Mm-hmm. He says Darilla.
Yes.
If anyone wants to heal Jason Darilla.
Nah.
I mean, I would love that. I would love that.
No.
No?
No. Please.
I feel like Jason Darilla is going to come back.
I think he is too.
I feel
I'm
like
so
he's
a
recurring
he's
character.
He's
going to
be the new chicken bear.
He's going to make a comeback.
He will. Always.
All right, that's it for them. Back to you guys.
All right, so we still have Gorilla Ball. I am going to cast De Primo, which is a wind damaging spell, and send these people through the winds. I think it might hurt some people, but it'll at least get people out of the way.
Okay.
Oh, this could be very bad.
Well, I like it.
All right, De Primo! It's gonna scatter these people to the wind.
Is that one of your spells?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh. So it picks people up. People are being carried off. Is it aimable? Or is it just like everybody in this square is now gonna get blown to some degree?
I think everybody in the square is gonna get blown
Everyone's
to some degree.
Blown.
Except yourself?
No.
I'm
Everyone's
guessing.
Blown.
Sorry, everybody.
So let's all save against being blown prone. For that, let's roll higher than a 10, which you can add your dexterity modifier.
Okay.
And I'm just going to tell you right now, Gorilla Bull and Darilla both make their saves, because I will not allow this.
Oh, yeah.
Graceful dancers.
Yeah. I got 18 with my dex in there, so.
You are on
it's
your feet.
It's those lupine.
Right.
You, know,
you got four.
Senses.
You got the 4 pounds.
Yeah.
Four points on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Great balance.
I got an 8, so I fell on my back.
Oh my gosh! The wolf.
All of my
fell
legs.
Over. Ooh. Legs in the air.
Yeah, I got a 4.
You were
I'm
also
sorry.
Down.
I'm so sorry.
But all of the spectators who were in the way,
mm-hmm.
asking for your secrets, have been blown out of the way.
Yeah.
So that was good.
That was all I was trying for. Sorry, everyone else.
Okay.
You want to get back up on your feet?
Yes, please.
Do it. That would be your movement with track. Have you acted yet?
I haven't.
Then act.
So most everyone's been blown away, right? So they're not like right up.
Right.
And you didn't. I haven't done anything.
You're just
still
standing there. She is unstupefied.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's getting herself all angry. She's like, I'm a wolf and the wind is blowing me and I need to bite something.
So I want to go right in front of her and get in front of, between her and everyone else. And just kind of like, not. I want to kind of growl just to let her know that I'm in
like
business.
Friendly growl?
Yeah, but not like I'm going to attack. It's just kind of a like cautious.
It's like, what's up, growl?
Yeah, and then I don't know if I can do any more at this point, but if I can, depending upon how she reacts, I want to start to try to.
You want to hold your action?
Sure, yeah, I'll hold it.
Hold your action, see what she does.
Okay.
Is Amelia gone?
I get up. I'm over there.
Which one are you?
The white, the staff. Staff, that's not that
this one.
This one? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I get up and I aim to cast Incarcerus on you because I don't want to hurt you.
Okay.
So it's a level 2. 12. Incarcerus! Just ties her up.
All right. You're tied up. But it's your turn now. And you're a strong, strong wolf.
Mm-hmm.
You're wrapped magical ropes.
Can I snap them off with my teeth?
Roll a strength check.
It's like, does magical rope work like that?
Of course it would be strength. My strength is...
That's your strength as a human. Your strength as a wolf would be different, yeah.
We haven't
done your stats as a wolf.
Is it going to be the same? Because I've got these stats here.
Yeah.
Would it be wolf or dire?
She'd be dire wolf.
Okay, that's what I thought. So... basically.
So we're just
what am I looking for strength-wise?
Because we've built our rules on Pathfinder rules, this means we can go back to Pathfinder stats and borrow them when we don't want to make up our stats ourselves. So, the difference between a dire wolf and a...
Here, tell me which number I'm supposed to be looking at. This is super cracked.
It is. That's true.
The difference between a dire wolf and a wolf in Pathfinder is that a wolf is a little bit smaller and a little bit weaker. So I'm just giving our werewolf a bit of an advantage.
What is it that she needs here?
Strength.
Strength? So the strength is 19. Which
yeah, that's why I wanted to make sure that was accurate.
Oh, it's accurate.
Well, is that a plus 4?
Yes.
Whew. 22.
Holy cannoli!
Wow.
Dude, when you are this strong, you don't even bite off the ropes. You just flex. Flex and the ropes pop off.
Mm. You pop, pop.
Flex. And you still get an action.
I'm going to try and dodge around her to the nearest person.
Absolutely. So here's what we're going to do. I know you held your action for such a reason. Mm-hmm. I'm guessing you're going to try and intercept her.
Mm-hmm.
So let's play it like a grapple. You both get your strength modifiers, and then you roll against each other, and whoever has the highest roll wins.
Okay, so let's see. My strength.
Oh, I already know mine because we just established that.
Yes.
I think I'm the nearest person.
Oof,
yikes. Although.
Do it. Oh, spend that reroll on evil. That's where I like it to go.
Is 13 plus 1?
No!
Should have held that roll.
I have one more.
Plus one.
I have one more. Do I do it?
Is this really what you want to use this on? Because I assure you,
I
worse
think there's
going to
be worse things coming.
Damn it. That's no fun. Fine.
So I'm
I was really, the ropes were frustrating. Like,
yeah.
I got caught up in that.
Oh. That's a 21.
Yeah, I'm glad I did not spend that
again. Okay. So what happens
Yikes.
Is Jaina the werewolf goes to faint, goes to like do a little double dutch, like fast footwork, get around. The smaller, weaker wolf, but she just bursts some ropes off of her and, you know, is moon-addled. So as she goes to dodge around the wolf, like, gets a real lucky shot, gets in there, and you guys are now grappling.
Mm.
But Morgana won this round of the grapple and is you know, has got her teeth on your neck the way dogs.
But, you know, in a real friendly way.
But not by bite, not by. Friendly?
Yeah, you know.
Not you know, I down. Don't think that even as a werewolf, she's going to read the situation that way.
Yeah. No. Yeah. Probably not.
Hey, BSB Care gives Mac a reroll. I think.
Nice.
Because he appreciated you using the other one for evil, as do I.
That's my shtick, man. Thank you.
All right, it's Gorilla Bull and Darilla. Gorilla Bull is going to try and slap again.
Oh, no.
Because he's a dancing man. Slap at Tara.
Oh,
fail.
He's so distracted.
He's distracted. He's
so
fail. He does what all dancing men tend to do, which he becomes obsessed with his own body. Mm. So he's looking down, watching himself dance.
Watching those abs.
And he's like, look at my abs. And he's like, he tries to, he's like, slap, but look at me go. That's what's happening there. And Darilla.
I'm down for this.
Darilla's going to go after Amelia now because this is a wolf. So he's not going to. What's your AC?
11.
Dun, dun, dun.
Darilla's going to win that because of his bonuses.
What a jerk.
It's meet or beat, so.
It's what?
It's meet or beat, so you roll an 11, right?
Right, but he's got bonuses.
And her AC is an 11.
Yeah.
So you made it without bonuses.
Yeah. That's true. That is true. Guys, I made both of these guys up on the spot, so all of his stats are right up on the spot. So essentially, I'm cheating.
Yeah!
She said she was cheating.
Cheating is the boo.
Evil.
Yes.
You're absolute gonna, evil.
You came for the action, but you're gonna get the horn.
I love it when he was Trey. It might be my favorite thing. Llama, llama, llama.
3 points of damage.
Which was sad because when it landed over here, it was a 6.
Yep. I know. I totally saw that in minute.
Yep.
Right, disappointment. 15. I do have these two rerolls.
My sad.
Are you tracking our hit points?
No. I haven't heard anything.
Do you want some hit points? I lost 2.
I was wondering if you needed it.
I started with 10.
You only have 10 hit points?
This game. I had 14 before.
Full. No, you started full.
Oh, I start full? Yeah. 14 then. Let's do that.
You had some time in Jamaica to recover.
Oh, yeah. Boy, did I.
Okay. Mac, where are you?
I'm still, yeah.
Okay.
15 out of 18. I'm 17 out of 16.
Overachiever.
Right? I'm so healthy.
Okay. All right, it's your turn.
Yeah, just call that out whenever you get it.
Okay. So, I'm going to go flipendo on the Darilla.
You guys have any sort of plan?
Not really.
This is a wolf now, so you can't even discuss a plan with her. No. She's just a growl, bark, bark, growl.
Is there something else you can think to do?
I think that we need to get these, we need to get rid of these creatures somehow.
Mm-hmm.
How do we kill them is the question, and I don't want to do the murderous curse.
That concern for me is touching.
I tried to tie you up so you wouldn't hurt anyone and we wouldn't hurt you.
So will you, can we get you to kill one of these things?
No, she's absolutely uninterested in anything that isn't a person she can bite.
That is the truth.
Tag nabbit.
Them's the rules.
Them's the hot Harry Potter werewolf rules.
So we just have to get rid of them somehow.
Well, then maybe I can do a small explosion on one of them. I just don't want to have a big explosion, but a small one. If I do bombarda, that's just a small little explosion. So maybe I can explode one of these creatures. Seems such a shame. It was one of my grandchilds, I'm 100% sure. But
well,
sometimes you've got
the magical skills.
Very, very great job, but I must kill. So.
Learned her dark secret.
Oops.
And I love her more.
All right. Well, little, it is a 2, so does that mean I need to roll something to make sure I can do it right? Okay. I need at least a 10, correct?
Mm-hmm.
All right, come on, big money. Oop, that would have worked. That doesn't work, but I do have a reroll.
Oh, well, all right.
All right. And that
doesn't either, so, well, now I'm just SOL.
It's a 7, so what do you roll instead? What do you cast instead?
We need to make you an app where you can just shake it, and it
right?
just, like, generates.
It generates.
Get on that chat.
instead, you're going to cast
Aguamente. I shoot water from my wand.
Yeah, Aguamente. You shoot water from your wand.
Oh, good grief!
Yeah, so
I just
today.
I couldn't kill my. No, I just couldn't do it.
Yeah, it all was, right.
I wasn't in the right place.
I can try Bombarda. It's a level 2. Right. I've done this before. Let's do this.
I believe in you.
Con Darilla, Jason Darilla.
There you go.
Dadgum! Roll to see if he crits.
Nope.
Nope.
Still, no crit. It's still a hit.
Still a hit. What is Bombarda? What would the damage be from Bombarda?
A little baby explosion.
It's a little baby explosion. I thought it was.
Provokes a small 2D4. Explosion.
Mm-hmm. Is it 2d4?
Yeah.
All right.
And then the bigger one is 6d4.
Yeah, that's like blasts a wall.
Oh. The Dark Lord Manny Marco. Cast Teri on Teri, receive 1 hit point because Ooh. Evil!
Oh, yes! Wizardry!
I love evil being rewarded.
Right. So
thank you.
It's 4.
So I'm at 13 now, Dawn. Thank
Which
you.
Which is that, Darilla?
Yep.
Poor
yep.
Darilla.
Evil will always triumph
You're
because
right
good
to me.
Is dumb.
You just hit me.
So 4 off Darilla.
I'm Megan.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Is it me?
Are you going to hold your action to wrestle with Jaina, or?
Well, I mean, we're just basically still in
you're
grapple,
in,
right?
You're in grapple. I mean, you could use this time to get out of grapple.
Because I don't want to hurt her. I really am trying to get her out of this area
okay.
and somewhere else, like, away from people. But she doesn't seem very interested in me.
Mm-hmm.
yeah, I'll hold.
Okay. What you gonna do?
So she's actually grappling with me right now?
Yeah.
I'm gonna try and throw her off.
Do it. Same thing. You're gonna roll against each other. And you're gonna add your strength bonuses.
No!
Is that a 1?
I'm not allowed to do that again in this game yet.
Not on a natural 1.
Apparently, I'm just
Whoa.
Not into it today. What's
so
happening?
Strength bonus?
Yep.
So that makes that an 11 for me.
Yikes.
Well, you roll against a 1.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it's a plus 4, but
you're rolling. Just
I would have totally used a reroll for this.
So distracting.
I gotta go back to the ugly dice.
The ugly dice are the best.
Yeah.
So okay. So
you're still grappled.
Yes.
You're
that
just,
is
you just,
hideous.
You guys just rolled to get like rolled together and like fought real hard, but
can
you're
I,
still on top.
Then like, then for like, my bleh. Action, can I try to since I seem at least there to have a little bit of control, at least holding on to her, can I try and roll her in a particular direction?
Sure.
So I mean I want to go towards an alley or
there's
just,
an alley right here?
Yeah. I want to go that way.
Okay. Where move your minis towards the alley.
To the alley. There. No, that sounds like a cat. I don't know. I'm a very bad wolf, I guess.
Okay, Gorilla Bull and Darilla. Gorilla Bull attempts a slap on Tara.
Haha!
Darilla attempts a gag.
Tara goes, No, you don't do that. You.
They both miss. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
My grandchild made you.
Yes.
You can't hit me.
There must be something that they put on them. Makes them incapable of actually really taking me down.
At this point, Tirabella Zonk's grandchild, the maker of which one?
Oh, the Gorilla Bull.
Gorilla Bull?
Mm-hmm.
The maker of Gorilla Bull and another strange-looking wizard, the maker of Darilla, come like rush walking out, like they're trying to look real innocent
Power
because
walk.
These are super illegal creatures.
Mm-hmm.
But they've invested a lot of their time and energy into making them, and they would like to save them from destruction. So they're like scooching across the crowd towards you,
mm-hmm.
but trying to look real like casual,
mm-hmm.
but also go real fast.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll reach you at the end of the next round.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so
back at the top.
Mm-hmm.
Is that your granddaughter?
Yes, yes. Yes, that is. That is
time for chat.
That is Bella. It is her.
Catch up.
This is one of her. This is one of her creatures. But we don't have time right now. We need to handle them.
Do you think she would know how to handle it?
Potentially, but
okay. Well, I'm going to use Incarceris on this Darilla.
Yes, the Jason Darilla. Yes.
I'm going to use Incarceris on that, and you should try and get. She's got this handled.
I'll work on Gorilla Ball.
Get Gorilla Ball.
Yes, that sounds like a plan. I will also Incarceris.
Why?
Wow. You got so many crit today.
That's not even a damage spell.
After
this, you're just going to have to put that die on the shelf because it'll never work again. You're rolling out all of the crits.
Forever now.
Dropping twins.
I did not get the same.
So you Incarceris on Gorilla Bull.
No, she was on Jason Darilla.
Darilla.
Jason Darilla.
Darilla Bull now.
Darilla. Jason Darilla is now bound up with magical ropes securely. You get him so good, like you get around the ankles, like you're like a rodeo wizard.
Mm-hmm.
So like he goes down and then his ankles and hands come together. And he's just sort of like, so tied up. Gorilla Bull, though, he like does a sachet. And you miss.
Because he's dancing so well.
Mm-hmm. And you miss, so you're gonna cast something else.
Yeah.
Why don't you cast
Avis, launch a bird from my wand.
That's a good one. Launch a bird from your wand. What kind of bird do you launch from your wand?
Oh lord.
It's a sweet little hummingbird, isn't that lovely?
Oh, that's
I'm pretty sure it's
adorable.
A murder bird.
They are kind of like murder. The movie The Birds.
A little smaller.
It literally has a needle.
Yeah.
All right, so you guys are still in your grapple.
Mm-hmm.
Roll to see. If you beat her this time, you've rolled her into the alley.
Okay.
If you beat her, you've broken free. And you can go raise.
Ugly die, do not fail me. You go first.
8. Oh. That is not very good for me. Ooh.
That would be 13.
Oh. You break free. Now you can choose at this point whether you're going to attack this upstart dog that thought it could tell you what to do, or the nearest person. It's up to you.
I'm running back out into
the street.
Of course
you are. Of course you are. Who's the nearest person that you're going to attack?
You tell me. Who's nearest? What's going on?
It's one of us two.
Me. One of those two.
But I don't want you to come to me. I want you to go to that guy.
I mean, I will attack a random stranger, too. But it's whoever's closest. That's really what it comes down to.
Okay, great. Let's do that.
I was like, it's one of us, too. So you got to just pick which one. We're about the same.
Yeah, I see how it is. It's cool.
Well, since I'm already doing a very evil thing, I imagine I need to pounce on him first before I can get in a good snap. So I'm going to try and launch myself onto the person.
Do it.
Is that a strength or a separate thing?
It's against her AC.
Oh, my AC is 12.
Strength? Or what do you want me to roll?
Okay.
Or you want, like, dex or?
Yeah, I'd say dex for a leap.
Yeah.
Like that.
Just need the numbers.
Give her the numbers.
Give me the number.
It's gonna be high.
Yes.
Freaking dire wolf.
What is it that you
stats
need?
Stats are awesome.
What numbers?
Your dexterity.
Dex? Okay. I'm sending you the link too so you have it.
That would be lovely.
Dex is 15. Wait, let me. No, that's not dire. Dex is. Also 15. So,
yes. Oh, it's actually my normal dex.
I know.
I'm very dexterous. That would give me 11.
What did you roll?
Me?
What's your AC?
Me. My AC is 12.
Oh, barely missed.
Skated by.
Let me add this. You see two oars that you recognize. Jack Duke, Britishly handsome black Jack Duke, and his assistant, Eloise Popinjay, coming out of store over here. And they notice the commotion, and they're coming your way. Remember, everyone, that being a werewolf at this point in the Harry Potter universe is nigh on to illegal. And being discovered as a werewolf would lead Jaina to be imprisoned or killed.
They won't necessarily be able to tell by looking at her that she's a werewolf, right?
They won't be able to tell.
Just as
no,
long as you don't.
No, if they are well trained, they will, because that's the whole thing, is they make sure even students know what the subtle differences are.
Hopefully Jack's a big idiot.
Or is he?
But he is really British handsome.
We all know this because he announces it all the time.
British handsome.